Hello everyone, it's Justin Cross here. Gonna go ahead and put in another interview. What on earth kind of bug is that? It sure is pretty. Wow. He's loud. Oh, he found its way outside. Good. Anyway, speaking of bugs. I was talking to Ouija Board Obsession, and I finally got that last interview that everyone wanted, and I mentioned before, if you're a Christian, you're going to see a lot of interesting things in this interview, a lot of things to question as far as this woman's theology. Now remember, this woman is a very new Christian, or she considers herself to be a Christian. But within this, well, I'm not going to spoil it for you. But anyway, this is not part two, but actually part three of the Ouija Board Obsession interview. And I hope you enjoy it. All right, so let's get started here. A lot of people have been asking about okay. you.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's one girl, actually, who was actually one of your followers. And she ran into my channel a little while after yours, so when she saw the interview with you, she was actually really surprised to see that you and I actually started talking with each other and that interview even took place. But actually, you're one of the reasons she touched the Ouija board, and it freaked her out. You know how it is. People always say someone's name, and I'm coming after you, or they say some crap like that, and everyone freaks out, like, oh my god, there's a spirit that knows me, it's gonna destroy me, type thing. But, and that's how she contacted me.
Oh, really?
Wow. Yeah, it's kind of interesting. So the thing is, with her, it was a real joy for her, is my point, for her to see you and I actually talking out. There is another one, the part two, it never made it. And, oh, we're recording right now, just so you know.
Oh, okay.
But there's another part, too, to the interview that was never uploaded, just so people know. And you disappeared for a while. I didn't get your text messages. You said that the Bible was a false prophet. I don't get what that means. But,
yeah. Someone's acting up for some reason. You're bringing negative entities into my home.
Let me see here. In here, I have...
Because I don't want to talk about what I told you about that time, because at that time, I was battling, you know, with, you know, God and the devil, basically, you know? And I don't want to rehash that,
well,
you know?
Well, I want other people to be aware of it, because I did not see your videos. I never watched them, but I heard about them.
You never watch my videos? Okay.
I'm sorry. I don't watch videos on supernatural stuff. I don't listen to other people. I don't watch horror films or anything that has to do with supernatural stuff. I don't listen to what churches have to say about supernatural stuff. I get everything strictly from the Bible and from God. That's the reason why. That sounded horrible, okay. Didn't it? The one I said that. Oh, I don't watch your videos. I watch mine.
No, I'll just, that was the past. You know?
It didn't mean to be like that. I just never watched. I don't watch anyone's videos. As horrible as it sounds, but I didn't watch your videos, so I didn't know what you were talking about. I didn't know. Actually, I didn't watch your videos because I didn't know you were making them. When I heard about you making, because I remember you made some on the Ouija board.
Yes.
And,
I knew my other channel that I had. Yeah.
Yeah, and then you created the channel, the
Messenger of God. Mm-hmm. That one I created. That one.
I
and
heard.
Then I had deleted it. You know. Mm-hmm. So. You know. Yeah.
Well. Absolutely. a real man drinks Samuel Adams.
Never heard of that, you know.
No, that's not true at all. Prophets drink Samuel Adams.
Well, prophets don't need a drink at all, so.
They drink.
I mean, wine.
They drank wine.
With moderation, you know.
And they drank beer, because beer was actually what they drank during the time when Moses turned the water into blood. All the water in the sea turned blood. What they had was beer.
Drink with moderation.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. With moderation. A lot of people I know, a lot of real true prophets don't touch alcohol at all.
Yeah, exactly. Because, of course, you know, too much alcohol can lead to sinful acts. So.
Yeah, drunkenness. Okay, let's get back into what I was going to ask you here. So, where are you now? So I know what kind of questions to ask.
Well...
Hold on. First,
my last interview that you had.
We've got to know what even happened with that, because that last interview is not posted. I have it on my computer, but it's not posted.
Well, the first interview.
Okay, what happened? What happened between that time?
Well, after that, I don't know. I was supposed to get baptized at what was it? It was I think it was March 20th, I think, or something like that. I don't know, March 6th or something like that. And then come to find out, I couldn't find the directions. And it was in my email, and I was looking at my email, couldn't find it. I was, totally blind, you know, because at that point, I was basically trying, I don't want to say losing my faith in God, but basically, you know, don't want to talk about it. But as the demons were telling me that, once you go the right way, and, you know, you finally go in the right way, you're going to get attacked by these demons, and when I mean attack it by mentally, you know, they're gonna be telling you things and stuff like that. So I was kind of questioning my faith, you know what I'm saying? So
no, that's absolutely true.
My past, yeah. So basically, yeah. So at that time, I didn't get baptized, and then I got baptized. When was it? It was May 20th. I got baptized. Yeah. So God knew that it wasn't my time at that time was it June, I think, I was supposed to get baptized? I don't remember. Somewhere May, somewhere in there. I was supposed to get baptized. So he knew that I wasn't, you know, ready at that time. You know, because he knew what was going to happen. You know, so he waited a while, and then I'm like, okay, I'm ready to get baptized. And I, you know, so I got baptized, you know. So, yay. Yeah.
Well, that's interesting you say that. Just so everyone else out there knows. Well, no, first I'm going to ask you, because first I was going to say something until you said that. You said it was God. Why do you think it would be God?
It is God, because God speaks, you know, from the heaven. That is God.
Yeah, but why do you think that was God speaking from the heaven?
What are you talking about? Like, when he spoke to me and told me to do stuff?
Here's the thing. What I was just going to talk about, and I'll make this real quick so people know. When things happen as far as spiritually, and we're going to go to a church, certain things happen, odd things happen. I was taking a friend of mine who needed to hear the word of God out, and this is where you come under attack. All of a sudden, her and I got in an argument. We were on our way to the church. I've been in the church around 40 times. This time, couldn't find the church, got lost. It was very confusing for me. It was very odd. Looking up directions on the smartphone, could not get them. Smartphone died. Called up my parents to ask them where it was. They told me where it was. Kept forgetting. Driving around for so long that drove around for about an hour around all the blocks and could not find it. What this is it's a demonic tactic.
And that's what it was. Yeah, that was a demonic tactic. Yeah, that's why it was the work of God and the demons. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Not working together, but, you know, I was supposed to get baptized at that time. And God knew that I wasn't going to get baptized at that time and date because of what was going on. You know, I was, questioning my path, you know what I'm saying? Because of the demons, and I got God telling me, you know what I'm saying? So that wasn't meant, that date that was said I was supposed to get baptized wasn't meant to be. You understand?
Well, that's difficult. Because the thing is what you just said almost sounds as if you think that there's a written plan for us.
There is. God knows God knows what we do every second and what we're going to do, you know.
But you don't believe that warps to different things? You don't believe that there's a lot of different futures, that futures uncertain, that we shape it?
No, God does. I mean, he puts on a path where we need to be. Like, I had to go through all that to get to where I am now.
That's difficult, because that means that God chose everyone's futures and what they would do. And that means that people would go to hell. That means he written everything.
Because, I mean, the reason why, you know, people think that is because it's what, man portrays it to be. Man is telling you, live your life the way you want it to, not live your life the way God wanted you to.
So you believe that if you live your way the way God wants you to, then there's a certain path, there's a destiny for you then.
Yes, because if you're living your life the way you choose to, you're not really living your life. Once you connect with God, you're living the life that He wants you to live, that you're supposed to live.
So you believe that the Lord allowed that to happen. He didn't create it, but He allowed the demonic to do that, is what you're saying.
I'm not saying He allowed it, but He knew at that point of time what was going to happen. You know what I'm saying? I mean, that sometimes God sits back and let you decide. You understand? Your free will.
Yes, I understand that. Now let's get into these videos here. As far as, one of them was, you had the camera, and we're talking about God was somewhere in the house. You pointed the camera to the location, and there was light. And you... Does that not ring a bell?
God, no. I never made... I don't know. I mean, I wouldn't say God's in the house. I don't know. Well, that's weird. I don't know.
Well, then, this one is mistaken. One about angels.
About angels.
About, you believe that you've seen angels and Michael the Archangel?
Oh, that was the first interview. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. I didn't say God was in the house. God's everywhere. No, yeah,
this one wasn't the, it wasn't that one. That had to do with something that was, someone said something in your videos. Here's some basic questions that someone's asking. This was from Patrick. And I think that we already answered this one before.
Hi, Patrick.
Well, some people only... What is it? Well, maybe this was in our second interview and it never made it out. But I'm pretty sure this was in the first interview. Was, were you raised in a Christian home?
No. I mean, a good question. No, I wasn't raised in a Christian home. Basically, I was actually raised as a Jehovah's Witness, in my younger years. And then after that, my mom and father got divorced and she became Catholic. I didn't really go to the church. I did go to church and everything, but I didn't believe in the church. You understand? Because you get that vibe, if what they're preaching is wrong. You understand?
Yeah, absolutely. And
when I was around five or six, I went to the Jehovah's Witness meeting, whatever you call it. When I don't know why I still remember this, but they had said the devil's good, and I don't know why and how I still remember it, but that was kind of awkward and weird, That kind of scared me when I was young, to hear that. But no, wasn't raised in a Christian home. My mom is now Christian. She's very much, a religious person. I don't want to say religious, but she has a really good relationship with God, which that's a good thing,
Now, here's another one. He says, what are your thoughts about Jesus?
What am I thought? What are you...
That is a very broad question, isn't it?
Yeah, I love Jesus. When Jesus comes down in the judgment day, when he comes... in the clouds and everything, I'm going to be, praising him, That's how I think of him. I love him to death, I mean, that's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to love Jesus because he, basically died for our sins,
All right, and here's an interesting one. I'm curious about this. As far as your belief system now, do you believe that the Bible is the last word, the only word of God?
That's, honestly, yes and no, because honestly, what God had told me was basically that people that read the Bible constantly, I mean, it's a good thing to read the Bible. God is not saying, steer away from the Bible. He wants you to read His